Okay, Michael, so we've talked about PCA and ICA, and they both work remarkably well in the specific domains that they're designed for, and they've been applied for decades on a wide variety of problems for doing this sort of feature transformation. But I'm going to just very briefly describe two other alternatives to sort of give you a notion of the space, okay?
Sure.
Okay. The first one is kind of irritating, but I feel obligated to share it with you. And it's called, well, it's got many different names, but I'm going to call it RCA just because I like the symmetry. And RCA stands for Random Components Analysis. So what do you think Random Components Analysis does? This is also called Random Projection.
I'm going to guess instead of finding dimensions with, say, high variance, it's just going to pick any direction.
That's exactly right. What RCA does is it generates random directions.
And then I guess it projects the data out into those directions.
That's exactly right. It's like saying it picks a random P to a random matrix to project your data onto. This matrix is, in some sense, just any random linear combination. And you want to know something? It works. It works remarkably well.
At what, though, in terms of, like, reconstruction?
At reconstruction, well, not particularly well at reconstruction, but you know what it works really well? It works really well if the next thing you're going to do is some kind of classification.
Mm.
Now, why is it you think that it actually works? Can you imagine why just picking a bunch of random directions and projecting onto those random directions might work?
Well, it does mix things together differently. I don't know why the original data wouldn't work, and this would work better, unless the original data somehow is purposely made to not work.
Well, remember what we're doing here, right? We're starting with n dimensions, and we're projecting down to m dimensions, where m is significantly lower than n. So I've started with a bunch of dimensions. Now, remember, the real problem here is not that I can't gather the data from the n dimensions. It's that there's a whole bunch of them, cursive dimensionality. So I need to have a lot of data. So if I don't have a lot of data, at least certainly not an exponential amount of data, so to speak, and I project to lower dimension, why would random projection still give me something that helps with classification?
So it's as if it's maintaining some of the information from these other dimensions, even though there's fewer of them now. They're all kind of mixed together, but the signal might still be there.
That's exactly right. And because you projected into a lower dimension, you end up dealing with the cursive dimensionality problem, which is sort of the whole point of this, or one of the whole points of this in the first place. And really, a way I think of summarizing what you're saying is that this manages to still pick up some correlations. So if I take random linear combinations of all of my features, then there's still information from all of my features there. So in practice, at least in my experience, Michael, it turns out that M, the number of lower dimensions you project into, for randomized components analysis or randomized projections, tends to be bigger than the M that you would get by doing something like PCA. So you don't end up projecting down to sort of the lowest possible dimensional space, but you still project down to a lower dimensional space that happens to capture your correlations, or at least capture some of the correlations, which often ends up working very well for a learner or a classifier down the road. You can actually see how, in this case, you might even project into another set of dimensions, M, where those number of dimensions are actually bigger than the number of dimensions you started out with. This, in some sense, is almost exactly what we did with perceptrons in solving XOR. Basically, you're projecting into higher dimensional spaces by doing this. Does that all make sense?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it makes sense to me that it would be not as efficient in some sense as PCA, because it sort of reminds me of, you know, if I want to paint my wall, I can very carefully paint all the little pieces of it, or I could just splatter stuff at it. And it generally takes more when you splatter because you're not being as systematic, but it does ultimately cover your wall.
Yeah, I think that's an interesting analogy, and I'm going to go with an apt one. Okay, so this sort of thing works. What advantages does it actually have over PCA and ICA? Can you imagine one? There's one in particular which I think sort of jumps out at you.
RCA? Well, I don't know. Is that a good quiz question, maybe?
Sure. Let's make it a quick quiz.